stop number two on the Bassmaster Elite Series. A vast tract of South Carolina low country. Lots of history, epicurean, but new to these anglers.
Woo!
Time to decide on how much risk you want to take.
Woo!
Which of many rivers suit your style.
Ooh, yes.
How you'll play the tide. Choose well, and you can win it all.
Second stop of the year, a brand new destination with a whole new set of challenges and probably opportunities as well. Welcome to the Bassmaster Elite Series. Welcome to the Toyota Bassmaster Studios here. Tommy Sanders and Mark Zona and Winyah Bay, Georgetown, South Carolina. Brand new place and a lot like the places we've been before as far as size goes. Places like the Delta, the Sabine, huge, vast tributaries to the ocean, but this is different.
Oh, this is a monster. And really, every single year that we've had on the Elite Series, there's always that X factor event that our anglers just do not have a lot of experience on that waterway, and this is the one. And the other side of it is, we're early in the season, and guys, do you play it close to the vest and stay close to our takeoff, or do you go for broke and make one of those massive 100-mile runs?
All right. Sounds like all you can stand. And this is river fishing, pure stuff. No sloughs, no lakes, no cutoffs. This is river fishing.
This is river fishing. And any river we go to, it's a shallow fisherman's dream.
All right. Well, as often happens at the Bassmaster Elite Series, about every third tournament, ready to go, ready to get started, and nature intervenes. We couldn't get started early on day number one.
There is a storm coming. We're supposed to launch, you know, blast off supposed to be in 10 minutes, but we have a big squall line coming. It's not quite here yet, but probably in the next 20, 30 minutes, it'll be approaching.
Man, look at it, raining, severe storms coming through, big squall line, winds at 40. You know, this has delayed the launch for us. And, you know, we're all sitting here in the parking lot right now and we're re-strategizing what to do.
We had a weather delay this morning. I had a pretty good squall line come through right at scheduled takeoff time of 7 o'clock, about 7:04. It's pretty intense here. It's much like a fog delay. In this case, it's a squall line, safety for everybody. We're going to have some pretty good winds this afternoon, but ready to get started here about 8:20 or 8:30.
Well, a short-lived storm, and now this field of 109 getting ready to take off, going to, well, 100 different directions, it seems like. But Carl Jochumson, one of those guys who, as you said, is going to make that big decision to take the ultimate risk and go the farthest.
Exactly right, and we've got a lot of anglers that are going to make this run to this general area up in the Cooper River, looking at about a 100-mile run. And the nasty part is really when you go across Charlotte Harbor. That's when it gets rough. Then you kind of head up into the Cooper River, and it really becomes its own environment. These fish stay here, live here, and the other side of it is big ones. I'm talking about giants live in the Cooper.
And Carl Jochumson, who's got to know during Gunnersville last year. Great job there. Doing a knockout job on day number one, 19 pounds and 11 ounces for a 3 pounds-plus lead over his next closest pursuer. Go out day two and a bit of a different story.
Definitely a different story. Carl Jochumson getting to his area, and he's not alone here. Leading the event, he is not alone. Boy Duckett in the area. Carl Jochumson trying to keep the wheels on, plagued by small fish. With that being said, Carl Jochumson really got to see the Boy Duckett show early on day number two.
Boyd catches a giant. This is where the mental challenges of fishing comes in. Not only do you have to drive 100 miles, you got to make it down here, and then you got to contend with what's in front of me. It's pretty frustrating, but I'm not going to let it get to me.
A complete turnaround on day number two for Carl Jochumson. That fish right there would be his lone keeper. Pound at 8 ounces, dropping from first all the way to 16th place. The opposite story for Britt Myers, calling his shots all day long. Every decision he makes is the right decision. A near perfect day on the water. Day number two for Britt Myers.
Yes. Yes, baby. Yeah.
Tide's starting to change. Look what time it is. I told you 11:30, 11:40, key fish. One more like that, and I might be leading this derby. Be honest with you, I've been there before. I don't care about leading it. I'm going to lead it the last day. The last minute, the last tick of the clock.
That's a giant, that is a mega bass. Oh my God.
Get her in the boat, boy. Give me some of that camera guy.
Brian, we caught him, boy. Yes. Yes.
The tide. 11:30. I told you 11:30. Whoever can figure the tide out 4 days will win the Derby. That's right there, boy.
And Britt Meyer's definitely put his time in for this event.
That's a big one.
Look at this flat on the Cooper River. It has little ditches and depressions, and the whole key for Myers was finding those depressions, really where they just kind of dipped down about an extra foot and a half deeper, and he said he idled this entire flat to learn all of those, and it's paying off here on day number two.
Woo! Well, that's a big one. What's going on here, man? What's up with that?
Just how good a day was it on day number two? The weigh-in would give you the exact numbers. How about 21 pounds and 7 ounces for Britt Meyers at that 16.8. For day number one, you've got the man in the lead after a couple of days. The South Carolina native in the driver's seat with two more days of fishing left to go. It was a big weigh-in. There are your top 12. 51 would progress to day number three, and we'll have all that action coming for you. Can Britt Meyers stay on top, a South Carolina guy? Taking it all the way home, we'll find out.
The Hook Bassmaster Elite on Winyah Bay is being brought to you by Nitro. Toyota. GoPro. And by Triton Boats.
Bassmaster Elite Series in this 2016 season at its second stop, first time ever in this part of South Carolina, the Hook Performance Fishing. Bassmaster Elite on Winyah Bay in host city Georgetown, South Carolina. A vast place with a lot of new challenges, as we say, possibly new opportunities. Certain guys have taken big time advantage over the first 2 days of fishing. This is day number three. We're down to 51 who will fish on this day. Take it down to the 12 who will fish for the championship. Day number four. We are a long way from that point right now. Day three will tell the tale for a lot of these guys. As you said, Mark Zona, many of them taking a big chance, a big shot, and making long, long runs.
No doubt. I mean, there is a lot of landmines. That's going to be our Yamaha Unlock the Lake. And really, when you run down to the Cooper River, you're fishing the perfect environment down here, okay? The area that our leader is concentrating, really a lot of guys in our top 20 are concentrating on. You've got grass, you've got stumps, you've got ditches, and not only that, there are lots of tournaments won here. It has the right genetics, it's the water that comes out of Santee Cooper, and that's the exact reason our leader, Britt Meyers, has put himself in this spot.
Where I fish is a giant rice field. There's drains, there's trees, there's spawning bass, there's everything going on in that one area. So I really think I could win off that area.
Got one. I don't know how big it is. It was decent though.
Yeah, baby. Oh, it's not a giant, but sure is pretty to me. There we go. Number one, baby. Pound and a half, pound and three quarter. Three of those and two giants, and I'll take it. Just keep me here, fish. You can't run around much. It's always nice to get an early fish. Always. Good one.
Britt Meyers, like day number two, a good fish comes early. A bigger fish came early yesterday, and he was so excited he, on the next cast, hooked his cameraman. We're going for Britt Meyers. But the guy who had the biggest day number two, 24 pounds plus, Kelly Jordon on the Santee River.
My run is not quite as far as a lot of the other competitors, and they're having to gas once, if I think twice. So that's just one less concern. You know, am I going to make it on gas? Time management, I have so much more time to fish than them that I can kind of relax and get in the groove and maybe fish a little bit better. They get like 4 hours to fish. I have about 7 hours to fish. So it's a lot more time. I have more time to kind of be methodical.
Be a bass, come on. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Look at that. Barely got it on the bottom jaw. Look at that. I felt about like the fish I missed a minute ago, but that's a solid 4.5.
Great start to the day. Kelly Jordon in a place he has a lot of confidence in. Obviously, he caught 24 pounds plus here yesterday.
We're going to slide back down to the Cooper River with Brett Hite. Here's the deal. If you really look at this tournament as a whole on day number 3, all the fish catches, the big fish catches we've seen have come on bladed jigs. Well, you have to include this man right here, probably the best on the planet with that bait right there.
You know, as you can tell, when we got here, you could see the bottom gin clear. The tide just had turned when we got here, started coming in. And really, it was way too low. The fish are still here. They're in the little depressions, kind of buried down in the grass, but we've had about a good solid hour plus of incoming, and now you really can't see the grass anymore. You can't see the stumps, and I mean, this is when they're gonna start biting right now, when it just starts filling.
Got him. I think they're eating that thing. Yes, sir. It's getting to be that time, boys.
Well, the other two have struck, first and second place, and third place, Brent Hite. They're joining the fray and obviously has a lot of confidence that he can get the job done in 2 more days.
To win another Bass Elite tournament would be awesome. I mean, it's real hard. You don't get the opportunity a lot. All these guys, that's what we dream about, is winning one of these tournaments. And if you could do it twice, it's just another exclamation point on the old resume. But, you know, I mean, we really thrived to win. And to win at this level is so difficult. It would really mean the world to me.
Performance Fishing Bassmaster Elite Series number 2 here in Winyah Bay in the low country of South Carolina, Georgetown. Look at that beautiful, beautiful area. Lots of things we're following today. Day 3 action going on with 51 anglers. Also taking a look, not too early, to get into the Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year points. There's your list right there. Our top 12 headed up by Marty, the Party Robinson, from here in the Palmetto State of South Carolina. Fourth place is that guy right there, Keith Combs.
Keith Combs really running in the opposite direction of a lot of our leaders. Has a milk run, call it 20 to 40 miles north of our takeoff. Been fishing the Waccamaw and the PD Rivers. And the other side of it is Combs has been fishing around a lot of other competitors. He said the number one key each and every day of this tournament is just slow down. And really, when he would see another competitor, he would put the brakes on and pick every single branch apart, and that's what has paid off for Combs.
That's a chunk. Look how round he is, man. This is where we came through this morning and we didn't catch him. We're coming back and we're getting bit. Thought that was going to be a really good one when I hit him, but you know, they're that tall. It's 13 inch fish, but he may cull. I think he'll cull something for us. We're gonna get every ounce we can.
Keith Combs, one of the most consistent anglers so far in this tournament, about 12.5, 13.5 pounds every day. On the other side of the coin is this man right here. Kelly Jordon, now he's been all over the place, 8.5 on the first day and 24.5 on day number two. He's got a limit in the boat here right now on day number three.
Yeah. Woo. That's what I'm talking about, baby, right there.
And did that sucker eat it or what? Why haven't y'all been doing that all day? Good Lord. That afternoon bite, baby. Woo, yes. Look at that fish. 4+, I'm sure.
Good upgrade for Kelly Jordon. As a matter of fact, he hasn't caught one that size since his first fish of the day. Now over to Brett Hite.
Exactly, Brett Hite down in the Cooper River. Not a lot of time left, and every day of this tournament, he has a limit in the live well here on day three. Every day late, he's caught a few key big ones.
Come on, give us a big one. We're out here. I'm baby stepping. That's a big one. It's a big one, whatever it is. Oh my gosh, it's a bass. Yeah! Woo! Mmm!
Had full faith it would happen, and so it did. Everything falling into place for Brad Hite. He knew the tide would get right as we visit the Shell, Rotella, Bassmaster Garage. A lot of things we talk about we can keep in the garage. Tide we can't keep in here, but that's an important element here.
Tide's a weird thing, and if you're somebody that grew up fishing tidal water, you know what I'm talking about right here. But if you've never been to a tidal fishery, here's the best way to describe it. Everything lives on a clock, and they eat on a clock. We all eat at lunch, dinner, and some of us breakfast. And here's the deal with a bass. You can be around dozens of them. And if you do not time it correctly, if you're not in that correct area when the tide gets right to dictate when they feed, you are in no man's land. It's little pockets when they feed, little 10 to 15 minute windows. And here's the best way to put it. You can be on the best spot, but if you're not there at the right tide, you'll never get a bite. And the other side of it is, whenever we're on a tidal fishery, you better know where you're running because the water is constantly changing.
Yeah, absolutely. Not just the bite, but other decisions you make, like when and where to go. I think Davey Hite may be a case in point there. Well, hey, Dave Mercer, we give him assignment. He follows through. And I think Dave Mercer, have you not? Yes, Dave Mercer has followed through this time. You've done your job. You found him.
He's alive. He made it back. I mean, we thought he was voted off the island at tribal council, but he made it back. One of the most shocking videos I've ever seen. Yesterday, the mud was a big player for you yesterday. Tell me what happened yesterday.
Well, when I got gas yesterday morning, just before going into Charleston Harbor, I had a little out of the way spot where I didn't think I'd have to wait for gas. Everything worked perfect. And the guy pumping my gas was super nice. And he said, hey, that little cut right there, you can just run out it and get in the intercoastal quicker if you want to save a couple minutes. I said, thanks. I'll see you back here at about 2:30 when I'm on my way back to get gas. He failed to mention that it was okay to run it in the morning at high tide, but you can't run through there in the afternoon when the tide's lower. You know, I got stuck in pluff mud, and it was horrible. It's actually my worst finish ever, but what do you do?
Zona, I have a question for you before we go. If you can tell me, is it true? There's a rumor out there that you bet Davey $188 that he couldn't make it over that mud flat. Is that true?
No. In all honesty, I would never bet a fellow co-worker and Bassmaster Classic champion anything like that, but I'm not going to lie. That was phenomenal.
Yeah, except for the times you've done it before.
Yeah, other times.
Once or
not
twice.
That time in general.
All right. Thanks very much, Dave Mercer. Now up on stage conducting the weigh-in. Let's get it going with Brent Chapman. Brent Chapman having his biggest day of the tournament so far. A 16-9. Oh, and up 7-1 on day number one. So what an improvement to make fifth place.
Absolutely. Now right here, rookie John Hunter, Kentucky. Very, very solid day, sitting with 40 pounds and 14 ounces.
Big drop off for Britt Myers. Had 21 pounds, 7 ounces on day number two, down to 8 pounds and 15 ounces. But still, that meaningful day number two keeps him high, third place in the standings.
From Texas, not a lot of bites, but definitely the quality living near Kelly Jordon. We haven't seen him in a long time, sitting in second place, 49 pounds even.
All right, and now to take a look at the best effort of the day, the man from Arizona, Brett Hite.
18 pounds even with 50 pounds and 2 ounces. The Hook Performance Fishing Bassmaster Elite has a brand new leader in B. Hite.
And the top 12 who will fish on Championship Day in Winyah Bay, South Carolina, Brett Hite. Great, great day three effort to take over the lead. Very, very tight, though, race as we take a look at our top 12, all the way down to Gerald, Swindle, Kelly Jordon in second, and Britt Myers in third. Top three, especially shoulder to shoulder, going to be some great competition. Championship Day next.
The Hook Bassmaster Elite on Winyah Bay is being brought to you by Berkeley.
Hook Performance Fishing Bassmaster Elite number 2, Winyah Bay, low country of South Carolina, and we are down to 12 anglers, 12 boats on this final day going for the championship, the $100,000 first prize. The top three very closely, very tightly bunched there, and the man on top, Brett Hite.
We have a little better conditions today. It's not going to blow 40 out of the north, and again, I'm going to make that 100-mile run to the Cooper River. Put my head down, fishing the one area that I've been fishing in. I know there's a lot of big ones swimming around there. Good thing with the tidal water is a couple times during the day, there's going to be those flurries. You just have to do that. You just have to capitalize on those flurries. And if I can do that, I got a really good shot to win, and that's what we're planning on doing. You know, the tides are real low. I wasn't real productive fishing on super, super low tide yesterday, so I decided to start here. Again, pretty much the same thing. It's a little depression with hydrilla all through here. Just spending a little time here. I mean, just waiting for that tide to get right so I can really fish that spot and be productive. So there's one. Sir, good way to start the day. Number one.
Always good to get a keeper early in the day, especially if you're starting the day with a lead. That's the case with Brett Hite right there. We take a look at his spot. Wide place there in the Cooper River. Of course, these are old agricultural lands back in the day that filled in, kind of turned into a big, giant, flat Britt Myers. A little ways down from him in this very special area that's been so productive, very much influenced by the tide.
If you can figure out the tide during the day and, you know, and get on those key spots, you can catch 2, 3, 4 fish at a time. In practice, I had a spot where I thought I could catch maybe 20 pounds on that spot.
Started on this area where I've caught some key fish every day. Second day, I caught a 6-7 right here. I mean, as crazy as it sounds, all I need, I've done it already. I had a 21 and a half pound bag already. I catch me a 20 pound bag. I think I can win it. Just gotta be patient. When tides, you're looking for those flurries. All week I've had those flurries, like boom, boom, two fish. The best flurry I had was the 2 4-pound flurry.
Let's see what we got here. Oh, it's a nice one. Come on, girl. Freaking 3.5 foot pounder. Look at that!
That's how we get this party started right there. Woo! Man, almost a 4-pounder. Boys and boys. I've never ever kissed a bass, okay? So right now, I just did. I promise, the first time ever. I don't have no chapstick, kind of why I did that. Man, we were talking about something. I got rudely interrupted here, but I'll take it. Holy smokes. I'm kind of jacked.
And with the tide being low early this morning, a key critical bite for Britt Myers.
Yeah, he's been up and down in this tournament. Yesterday, things were a bit down.
South Carolina, let's hear it for one of your very own.
You're not going to have those 20-pound bags every single day. So yesterday was a magic day. Today was not so good. As bad as this may sound, I'm kind of glad I'm not leading. I've been in that position before where I've led almost every single day, and that's a lot of pressure. Right now, I'm just going to, you know, relax, go try to figure them out. Because that, you know, if I beat the same, make the same cast I've been making the whole entire time, I know I'm not going to win the event. I know I've got to think while I'm fishing, make the right decision, and it may happen.
Welcome back to our final day coverage. You can't come here to the low country of South Carolina, not get your seafood fix taken care of. You go to a place like this, a place like Big Tuna.
We're going to be making our tuna tartare. Got some nice fresh tuna right here. I can do a bass tartare, I think. Yeah, I guess we'll have to go talk to Van Damme about that.
The one thing that I look forward to everywhere we go is the food. I can tell you, y'all have the best shrimp that I've had. Every night I've had shrimp all week long, and it doesn't get old. I mean, these are the best shrimp ever. So I love the food down here. I love the hospitality, and hopefully we can come back down here.
We only use local Bulls Bay shrimp, South Carolina, caught right here off our own coast. Season opens up next week. Put it in our secret breader, herbs and spices, straight into our fryers.
Boy, I'm not gonna lie, just very, very hard to watch that big tuna footage right there. I wanna put everything in my mouth at once.
Oh no.
No, I mean it. Out to the water right now, final day action with Kelly Jordon. Kelly Jordon, an angler we used to cover a lot in the top 12. Haven't seen him for a few years. Kelly Jordon will tell you, he knows these chances do not come along often. Not a big area, but so far in this event, it's had the right ones.
When you make the top 12, for me, I don't ever think, well, at some point I'm just going to try to maintain and hopefully finish in the top five still, or that's not a goal. When you make the top 12, if you're in contention, your goal is to win the tournament, and it's going to be my goal to win this tournament until I have to leave. So if I can get these suckers fired up or figure out the little deal or the area where they are, fish are here to blow this thing open, because the big ones were in here and they were biting. And it was happening fast. Barely hooked. Barely hooked.
Look at Kelly Jordon, everything is all good.
Jordon, sure, that's it. In the Santee River, over to the Cooper River, and back to Britt Myers, third place to start the day.
We couldn't even fish this place effectively yesterday. It was pretty much, we gave up on it. It was so bad. The wind was blowing in here and it's shallow. You can't be bouncing around on a trolling motor and trolling motor's coming out of water and you're fishing in 3 foot of water. It just spooks them.
Britt Myers dealing with the changes, certainly got dealt a good hand on day number two, but all through this tournament, he's felt he's had the right bait as we go to our Taste the Bait segment.
No doubt about it. Our Skeeter Taste the Bait's going to be that right there, a half-ounce chatterbait, a bladed jig. And really, the key's been that trailer. It's a 3.8-inch Hite trailer. And if you look at his spot, he's got five key depressions on this massive flat. And when that tide dips out, the top of the flat gets to about a foot and a half of water, and the depression is 3 to 4 feet with a mix of hydrilla and wood. And really, when that water would suck out and push those bass into these depressions, that's when that chatterbait was at its finest. And really, throughout this event, those depressions, knowing where they were at, has been the number one key.
know what this is. That's a bass.
They hit it funny. I'll take her. It's a keeper. You never know what that fish could mean. Catch a couple of giants with her and good deal. Catch me five and I can calm down a fish like Kelly Jordon. I guarantee if you're watching Bass Live, you've been watching Kelly Jordon. He's just like, just having a good old time. No matter how you do, you just catch a decent little bag, you're gonna get at least top five, maybe top three. That's not a bad couple days work.
Britt Myers, the really big ones haven't showed up yet on this final day, but he's obviously keeping it very, very positive. He knows that big things could happen today to him as we move over to a guy who has steadily gained momentum each and every day through the course of this tournament.
Going and fishing on day four is what we all strive for. You know, you're always taking steps. And to make it to day four and put yourself into position to win, I mean, that's what we work for all year long. So to have that opportunity, I couldn't be more excited. The tide is pulling these fish out to a little depression. I've kind of got the sweet spot dialed in. And man, they're in there and I'm just picking the spot apart.
Number three.
Tides, obviously, the tides were better earlier in the week. The tides are getting less and less favorable. But at the same time, I know there's a lot of fish in there, and it seems like you can catch the fish. You just got to keep adjusting with them and figure out what they want to eat for that, you know, for that particular tide.
Right. Got that one. That's a better one. There we go. Number five is a little better. Wasn't going to come off. There we go. Number five. Now they're about to get bigger.
On a morning that's been pretty slow, Brent Chapman putting things together and actually getting a lot of bites. Now over to our rookie from Kentucky in his second event, John Hunter.
First started fishing about the time I could drive. That's when I got my first boat. Went to college for baseball scholarship and didn't love it like I thought I would. Got on the fishing team and had a lot of success in the college fishing ranks, and I was able to qualify through the Northern Opens my first year trying. It's a really tough thing to do, and I feel really fortunate to get it done the first time I tried. But yeah, and so now I'm here fishing the final day of my second Elite Series event.
Well, John Hunter would have a bad final day. Zero fish, but a solid performance. Back up in the Santee River with Kelly Jordon.
We got a Texas rig lizard on now. There's one.
Oh, gosh.
Like that, didn't get it. I think they're probably spawning in here. And I tried a Senko yesterday. It really didn't work in the pads real good. And it was windy. I figure if I come by a bed with this, there's, of course, it may be a little early for them to be on. This, it might be the best, last hour might be the best for this, but they ought to take a shot at this. Better than nothing, right? The little ones are out.
Kelly Jordon trying to get some of the magic going, trying to ignite what happened to him on day two in this special place, which was truly for him, Amen Corner.
It's fresh, it's new, excellent tournaments. Kind of like a Masters event. They're having a Masters next door in Augusta. Hey, we're here in South Carolina, same week. This is kind of like a Masters course. It's very, very tough, and it ought to be a spectacular finish for somebody whoever wins. So I hope it's me, and I'm gonna fish that way, and hey, if they bite, I'll catch them.
The Hook Bassmaster Elite on Winyah Bay is being brought to you
boats.
So much history here, the terrific architecture, the live oaks, and everything else that makes this scene perfect. Brent Chapman having a good day numbers-wise, having no trouble catching all the fish he wants to catch, but knows he's got to get the size up if he wants to play near the top. Right.
Got that one. Little one.
Where are the... Oh, that's a better one. Thought it was a little fish. Get in here. That one will help.
Not a lack of action right now for Brent Chapman, getting bit about every 10 minutes. Back up into the Santee River with Kelly Jordon. The scary thing for our leaders, he has been around the meet really the entire tournament. Early on this final championship Sunday, he's been plagued by small male bass. He needs to relocate that big school.
So normally when you see that, that's the buck bass coming in, you know, shallow spawning areas, but they're where I've been catching the big ones. So what that probably means, and I've fished accordingly, at least the best I know how for this group of fish, is they were the farthest ones in because they're small in the little bucks. And so now they're still the farthest ones in, if that makes any sense. So I've been catching pound and a halfers. Of course, they may be the only ones biting today too, but. So you'd think the big ones, since it's the river's dropping, they're gonna be farther out. I mean, that's got to be where they are. But they're not biting yet. That's a bass. I have caught a lot of fish right there. I don't know why.
Kelly Jordon in this really small corner of the Santee River here, a place that he's been dissecting all week long. Still waiting for the big ones on the final day. Brett Hite, one fish in the boat, and he's waiting for the rest of the fish to show up and the tide to get right as well.
Just going to keep on chucking them line then and just go from there. We're going to run back over to the honey hole here. Flippers aren't cold. All right. That was a long time in between bites, but that's a good one. All right. Just got a little rally. We got a rally. Got two decent ones. Just need, three more bites. It can happen real quick right here.
Hey, it's been a lot slower on this Sunday than Brett Hite thought it was going to be, but still sitting on two quality fish. Now over to Britt Myers. He has a limit and needs to upgrade.
Shady dock. South Carolina's known for some dock fish. The wind's starting to pick up, which is what you want. First morning, I had a fish come up and bust a bait right in front of me. It was a 4-pounder when I caught it. In practice, that happened one time, and it was a big one, too. Tide's coming in. This spot gets the best when the tide's getting higher.
The freaking beast, whatever that was, dude.
I might have broke that in off if it hooked up. As excited, as jacked up as I was on that bite. That was not a 12-incher. Every big fish right now is freaking mega steps in this tournament. You keep throwing a chatterbait to get a big one, or this trigger a big one. This is one of those baits I didn't even, in practice, I didn't throw. I threw a little bit, took a hook out of, had one or two bites, and didn't feel like they were, didn't get enough bites. But we didn't have those slick conditions. Those bass can see those birds. They won't bite it when the birds are on top of it. I'm telling you, this is the time. The tide is right. Nah, that's a little one. Did it call that one though? Hey, that adds up, dude. Keeps making that 5-pounder more sweeter. More sweeter, did you get that? That will get rid of it, by God.
Not a big one by any means, but that bass right there will cull very critical ounces.
We started out tight this morning among the final three, and boy, it's still tight. This is gonna be an old-fashioned nail biter at the weigh-in.
Georgetown, South Carolina, are you ready? Let's get ready to win! He is 55 times in the top 50, twice a bridesmaid. The question is today the day? From Lake Wylie, South Carolina, Britt Myers!
The goal is to have a seat right there in our hot seat. Looking for 3 pounds, 5 ounces, 9 pounds, 5 ounces. A brand new leader in Britt Myers. You are very calm in the water. Look out at this crowd and tell me, are you calm right now?
Guys, if I finish 10th, it's all good for me. I had a great tournament. Life is good. Like I said, no matter how I finish, guys, you guys made me feel like $1 million this week.
Okay, go kick back and relax. We'll bring through our final two. From Palestine, Texas, KJ Kelly Jordon. Digging deep in that Skeeter Yamaha Livewell. What's he got? This is going to be very, very close. 49 pounds even, sitting in third place. He needs 7 pounds and 4 ounces to take the lead. 6 pounds, 3 ounces.
At Lake Douglas, my boys cried when I finished second place. Guys, I want y'all to celebrate if I finish second place, because I'm telling you, life is good either way.
The true attitude of a champion right there. Well, let's find out what happens. Our very next angler, all the way from Phoenix, Arizona, B. Hite. Brett Hite. Rick, come on, let's get side by side, guys. This is our moment. We're gonna find out who wins this event. Looking for 6 pounds, 2 ounces, 5 pounds, 13 ounces. Brett Myers mashes him in front of his hometown crowd. Your champion, ladies and gentlemen. How do you like the sound of that?
I just want to know one thing. There's a lot of pro anglers watching us right now, okay? And a lot of them are my friends, and I've cried when they've won tournaments because I felt so happy for them. So, I mean, I can't even explain what's going on. I didn't even think I could win this event coming back.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we started with 109, and now one remains. South Carolina's very own Britt Myers owns the South Carolina stop of the Bassmaster Elite Series. The 2016 Hook Performance Fishies Bassmaster Elite Series champion, Britt Myers, presented by Go RV.
All right, almost never happens. The whole team cheers past, and it's happened the last three classics, and it happens here. A guy wins in his home state and a popular victor there in Britt Myers.
You have to give it up. He's as close to a local as we could have in this tournament. He did all of his homework and got the job done. And the other side of Britt Myers, he's one of those anglers the rest of the field highly respects. You never hear a bad word about that guy, anything.
No,
and the other side of it is, we try to stay unbiased. you try to stay unbiased, but you know what? That guy deserved that.
Everybody pretty much pulled for Britt Meyer.
No doubt.
Hats off to him. We're headed next to a totally different new animal, a tournament where it's split between two lakes, and that Lake Norfolk, Mountain Home, Arkansas, and Bull Shoals Lake, where we have been before. What are your thoughts about that?
My thoughts about that, that's going to be the biggest curveball that our Elite Series anglers have ever faced. They always practice for one event on one body of water. This will throw a stick in the spokes of the majority of the field.
2 days on Norfolk, 2 days on Bull Shoals. We will see what happens when we see you next time on the Bassmaster Elite Series.
5 pounds, 13 ounces! Britt Meyer smashes him in front of his hometown crowd! Your champion, ladies and gentlemen!